This is a great day at Harlem. I mean, everybody's happy. Everybody's enjoying themselves. The real Harlem basketball players.
And Harlem is the beginning, the start of everything.
I wish all of y'all could be here to witness this great day in Harlem.
But Rucker put this Harlem on the map.
John Easley, real Harlem basketball player, one of the board members. Listen, festivities, you got a lot of old timers in there, man. A lot of history. And this is what real Harlem basketball players is about. You see this here? This is significant. This is significant because it's who we are. It's not who we were.
Oh, John, what we're doing here is we are giving awards away to the great Harlem basketball player. And I happen to be one of them.
And you're a great one.
I'm more happier. The real reward for me, the award for me, is the people that's here. So many things happen in our times of tribulation of life. And I've been called everything but a child of God, but they didn't know I was a health nut. And now they know I'm a child of God.
Joe was one of them coming up. I was the little boy living in building 4, and I couldn't see. So I had the crate that I had to go to Sloan's, and I always tell that story. And then I got the crate, so now I got on the crate, and now I can see, because I couldn't see before. But I couldn't take that crate home, so I had to hide the crate in the bushes. And every weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday was special, you know. Just watching when the Doc came. I remember when he came up on the train station. Came out the train station, you know, put a Converse on.
And he came and they called him the Doctor. But he had to play this game against another guy who is from Harlem, who we all knew, but he ain't know, they ain't know. So the newspaper said, Dr. J. So this guy said, there's about 3 million doctors in New York. But it ain't but one destroyer that's up on 8th Avenue. The rest of them is parked down there in the water. All right? Let's stand up for Joe Hammond. Come on now. Let's stand up for Joe Hammond.
One more thing. One of my coaches here, my first coach, Sam, David Days. Come here, Sam. You got to come up here, Sam. I had a lot of great coaches. I had Don Laddery. I had coaches that came out of retirement to play with me. Floyd Lane. I mean, Freddie Crawford, Bob McCall, even El Zorro. All of them showed me something about a basketball. And that puts together the story. And maybe that's why I got that name.
I mean, you know, 125th Street is a pro thing. And you had guys from all over the world, pros all over, Bronx, everywhere, 125th Street. But a lot of guys from Harlem were down Mount Mars Park.
So you have a lot of legends here, and they're honored. Holcomb Rucker.
That's right.
The legendary Holcomb Rucker is being honored today.
Mr. Rucker grew up on my block.
Holcomb Rucker was my teacher.
The program he started is duplicated all over the world.
That park is not enough. 155th Street should be Rucker Avenue, Boulevard, whatever you want to call it. But we as a people gotta make it happen.
Presenting the event that happened yesterday at 155th Street at the Rucker Park, the games between Philadelphia and Harlem. We trying to revive a tradition that started way back in the 1940s by Mr. Rucker.
I'm double honored because I'm being inducted in the Hall of Fame as a contributor to basketball, along with my mentor, Holcomb Rucker. It's a double honor for me. This is a great day in Harlem, and it's doing Harlem Week. Harlem Week in Harlem.
Summer night in Harlem. Man, it's a really hot. Well, it's too hot to sleep. I'm too cold to eat. I don't care if I die or not.
It's still contributing. And probably gonna contribute until the day he died. And then when he died, then he gonna get about the casket and talk to us one more time. So sit back in your seats, everybody. Here come Mr. Bob McCullough. I'm not gonna tell you nothing about him, because he's gonna tell you everything about him.
In his life and time, he sung a lot of songs. He's made some bad rhymes. He's acted out of life on stages with 10,000 people watching.
30 years ago, I met a man by the name of Bob McCullough. Now, I was a young coach, starting as the athletic director and basketball coach at Benedict College. But that would start me to come to New York City, because Bob said if you come to New York City, you can get some winners. Bob averaged over 36 points, and he was the leading number two scorer in the nation.
When I was playing in St. Nicholas, where you live, Hank, and we won the championship, and I was up for MVP, and Bobby Jenkins told me there was another kid that was gaining on me for the votes. I said, who is that? He said, Tony Greer. Scored 25 points coming off the bench, Bob. You averaging 28, but he averaging 25 coming off the bench. I said, what? Oh man, I gotta watch him.
Mr. Snooky Walker is not here today, but through a lot of work, I have his son and his wife present in this room today.
And they have the only living player who played in the double championship game from City College, the 1951 team that won the NIT and the NCAA all in 1 year, Floyd Lane. Floyd Lane is now 92 years old, and he's here today.
We are fortunate enough to have three of Mr. Black's daughters present here today. Stanley Stackhouse, Lincoln Sessom, Kimmy Miller.
The game of life. How to navigate, how to get over the hurdles, and how to believe in yourself.
When I walk in this gym, you know, and you talking about I'm too small, I'ma show y'all. And what he did was gave to all the rest of us the engine we needed to just go on and knock him out. All right? That's right, I'm talking about Nathaniel Tiny Archibald.
I know this is a Harlem thing. I was born in Manhattan, and most of the time I spent in the Bronx, and I'm in Brooklyn now. I tell people I'm a New Yorker. That's what I am.
I went to college in Texas, and Archibald had just got through naming MVP. Whatever he did, he was killing. He was killing. And I had, I was a freshman, 17 years old, and they were so hyped up about Nate Tiny Archibald. So they said, where you from? I said, I'm from New York. Do you know Nate Tiny Archibald? I said, yeah. They says, who are you to him? I says, that's my cousin.
Man, Tiny be out there the first one in the park, man. Be dark. He be dribbling that ball. And so that's what it takes. It's not easy. It takes endurance. It takes commitment. And we have that commitment.
You know, my father started out as a chubby little kid. He fell in love with basketball. He attended Frederick Douglass Junior High School, where legendary Holcomb Rucker was a teacher and his mentor. Then my dad went to Samuel Gompers. He made consensus All-City at Samuel Gompers High School in the Bronx. He accepted a full scholarship to play basketball at St. Bonaventure University. Over the three seasons, he averaged 22.5 points, 10.3 rebounds. And during his first varsity season in 1961, Dad helped lead St. Bonaventure to his first NCAA tournament appearance and a record of 24-4. 2021 Harlem Basketball Hall of Fame inductee, my dad, Fred Parker Sr.
This is real special. But this is Freddie, and he started the first, what the thing we had, the Future Pro.
Yeah, right.
And Tony Greer was the coach.
Yep.
And when I got left back, they took me to Delaware State.
There's a lot of guys that went on the greatness that Mr. Page personally taught.
All right, my name is Michael Holloman, and I have the privilege of making the presentation on behalf of Pee-wee. I will have the honor to present this award to the only player I've ever seen, and I've seen him play lots, who never had a bad game or who did not excel in any big or championship game in HBCU.
What Harlem has been to me in my life is what you would call the great motivator. Because it's the spirit of Harlem that's inside me that I'm never going to stop loving Harlem and the fact that I was born in Harlem Hospital. I'm never going to stop going nowhere and reflecting anybody but Harlem. You understand what I'm saying? Because I don't think I would be what I am all over the world on a global level had it not been for Harlem.
Saturday night in Harlem, everything's all right.
The real Harlem basketball players have put on a great event. This event will be talked about for years to come.
Once again, the real Harlem basketball players want to thank you for your support and coming out and being family with us tonight. Get home safe, drive safe, and we'll see you next year.
Carl Green has been a mentor to many of us, and he got many of us going out to the Globetrotters. But even more important, he was an Emmy winner.
Buster with Buster with Buster. I mean, I can't tell you what he did for me because he raised us up. He actually made us men.
And Harlem is the beginning, the start of everything. We have more basketball players come out of Harlem than any other group. And we all over the world. We're not just in the block no more. We are all over the world.